Thanks for also from my side for joining so numerously in the UK, and I will from the central office here in Brussels give you some news about KNX International. So I will tell you a little bit about the past year. The past year has not been easy, but it was remarkably positive for KNX. I will tell you a little bit about that, and I will also tell you about upcoming novelties that you can expect from the KNX system, and also from the ETS, of course. I will switch to the next slide. In 2020, we had a 12% increase in the tool sales compared to the year 2019. 2019 was the best year, the best KNX year ever, but we were still able to top that by 12%. This is remarkable, because of course we all know about this pandemic going on, but in spite of that, we managed to still top that, and we were able to welcome the 500th member in KNX International. That was Sony. So Sony joined KNX last year.
I don't remember. Why? What's good?
So some people ask us, well, is this astonishing that in spite of a pandemic, KNX is still able to grow? We always try to be one step ahead of the competition. Of course, needless to say to you that there is competition out there in the home automation and building automation field. In the past years, we have tried to be one step ahead of the competition on three different fronts. First of all, we have invested heavily in making KNX a more secure automation system, and proving that you can improve security still with KNX. So the first KNX secure devices came on the market last year. So many different members, the head offices of many of your members have come with secure devices, many concentrating on securing the IP connection towards a KNX installation, but also some of your head offices have also launched products to secure radio frequency. And possibly in the near future, we will also see some devices that also secure twisted pair communication. We have, with the members, we have invested numerous man hours in really trying to finalize this standardized IoT interface towards KNX. I will try to explain you in a next slide what this is all about. So the third party IoT interface is a common KNX standardized interface towards existing installations. So not everybody doing this on his own, but trying to go for a really standardized way of doing this. Because that's the message of KNX. It's all about having a common approach to all of that, even if we're interfacing to KNX. And the third thing is that, we have had our 30th anniversary last year. But the 30th anniversary is not about how boring this system is and it doesn't change anymore. No, what we try to do is still improve this this system you all know and you all install with still novelties on the classic system. I will tell you also a little bit more in the next slide where I have tried to give you the bigger picture. Also, a lot of people ask me, yeah, well, can we still improve after 30 years? Yes, if I can use the phrase from Barak, I think, yes, we can. But we must always try to improve on top of the existing system. What we may not do, as some other systems do, is we throw everything in the bin and we start all new. I don't think we can afford that. KNX, we must always build on top. And what we also want to do is we want to extend the current KNX system towards using more and more IP-based communication, also as an extension. So we don't want to throw away the kit with the bathtub. We want to build on top of what we have and use other networks to communicate next to the current TP, the current radio frequency, etc. And if we extend to IP, then of course we must use the security mechanisms that are in place there. We cannot just impose ours onto that because that would be unacceptable. And what we also want to do, we want to give more meaning to our data. So if you receive a dimming up command, of course we have our way of doing that or solving that, but we must, if we make the move to IoT, we must give the IT business already the semantics. It's maybe a difficult word, but we must provide them the meaning of our data because that will improve the planning stage. It will improve configuration and it will improve the data towards BIM, building information modeling. So KNX in the meanwhile is a lot of things to a lot of people. A lot of people say, I've got everything I need. Thank you very much. You don't need to extend KNX. So we keep those people happy. We want also to attract other people that don't do business with KNX today. So we have to also make KNX appealing to those who want to discover new horizons. And we also want to make KNX appealing to people who say, well, I don't care much for KNX, but your data there in your in these homes and buildings, they look very interesting. We want to make, we want to base ourselves on this data to make our own solutions. We want to provide services based on your data, whatever they're coded, I don't care, but please provide me this data and I will make interesting things on the basis of that. And of course, our common goal is KNX is about interoperability. So we do things together and we provide our data and then you can do even more with that. So the key word in KNX remains interoperability. I've got an announcement to make on the 2nd of April. So we didn't want to launch that on the 1st of April because we don't want people to think it's an April Fool's joke. We want to launch a new flavor of the ETS professional. And this flavor of the ETS professional is a possibility to create one project with up to 64 devices. As you know, we currently have the ETS Lite, we have the ETS Professional, but there is nothing in between. So if you buy a license of the ETS, you can do so for training purposes. So you have this 20 devices license, or you can buy a full-fledged ETS Professional, which allows you to create projects of 64 or 65,000 devices. So the full version, but there's nothing in between. So if you have a home, you don't have a proper license for that. And from the 2nd of April, we will provide this possibility of licensing the ETS Pro for one project with 64 devices. The question that is for sure going to come is what is the price of this? It will be 350 euros. So instead of 1,000 or the Lite, which is I think 200 without any rebates, you will have a 350 euro version. And that should lower down the barrier for some of the techies amongst our customers. We have a lot of people asking us, yes, I'm very interested in KNX, but you know, 1,000 euro, sorry, guys, this is way too much. If you would provide a version that is cheaper, then I would make something with KNX, but 1,000 is too much. So that's our answer to these people. Also, an advantage compared to the ETS Inside version is the fact that this version will allow you to also design things with products with having plugins. This is not possible with the ETS Inside. Okay, I wanted to give you the whole picture. I hope I'm not spending more time than I need, but still I want to still share the whole picture of what we have up our sleeves for the coming months and years. So I have depicted here the system as we know it today. So the system consists of twisted pair lines and areas onto which you can hook TP compatible products. There is the possibility also to extend your system with a IP line onto which you can, of course, via KNX NAT IP, be it secure or unsecure, you can visualize data, for instance, on a smartphone or on a full-fledged panel. Of course, this line, so you could also add a radio frequency line to it, but this is the first drawback. If you want to integrate radio frequency in twisted pair, you need to do that with a full-fledged line. So you must connect to the main line. And this is not good. If you want to extend a TP installation with one or two radio frequency products, this is a drawback. So for solving this, we will launch with the ETS6 a possibility to include a so-called segment coupler. So a segment coupler is you just branch off the TP line and you add one or more radio frequency products to that. So also an extension to radio frequency will be the possibility to include so-called KNX radio frequency multi products. What are multi-products? Multi-products are products that can communicate on multiple radio frequency channels, current products can only communicate on one single channel. A multi-products will be able to use four different channels. So these are more robust for doing radio frequency communication. And there will be also a so-called slow channel. And this slow channel is very good for products that have a battery. So if you want to include battery-driven products today in KNX, this depletes this battery very fast. So we needed a solution for instance, I have depicted here a valve, and this valve can then also be can use radio frequency for communication, and this slow mode allows it to sleep most of the time and wake up at certain specific intervals, so that the radio frequency does not deplete the battery in a very short time, and you have to exchange the battery. So this will be also possible with ETS6. So ETS6, by the way, will be launched in autumn of this year. Another possibility will be that you will be able to insert so-called secure proxy. A secure proxy will allow you to couple a unsecure twisted pair to a secure radio frequency product. For instance, if you have an outside movement detector, today it's better that a hacker who would be outside your home would not be able to infiltrate in your TP installation. Today, this is not possible, but it will be possible from ETS6 onwards, because you will be able to include a secure proxy that actually seals off your twisted pair installation, even if you are able to eavesdrop on the radio frequency signals outside. A next thing will be, of course, this IoT extension. This IoT extension, so this IoT gateway, we have now finalized the specifications. So we hope that these IoT gateways will see the light in the course of this year from certain manufacturers. Some manufacturers are busy developing those. So what will these IoT gateways allow? First of all, it will allow a cloud application to fetch data from an underlying KNX installation in a standardized way. And also this phone inside the installation will also be able to fetch data from the installation in a standardized way. And a thing which will probably see the light in 2022 is the use of IP networks to do KNX communication. This is still a futuristic extension, but one of our members is already working on this using Thread networks, which are also used by Apple, for instance, in their in their products. So the Thread network will be usable to exchange KNX information on these networks. So this is referred to as KNX IoT Point API. It's a difficult name, but actually you can remember that this is all about doing KNX information exchange on another network than twisted pair or radio frequency. And also very big data will be able to exchange data between, for instance, storage systems, or other devices that send bulky data over HTTP. So we also want to be able to extend our system by devices that send very bulky data. And for instance, between this storage system and a panel, these devices could exchange data via this point API communication. And also, this data would be transportable towards a cloud system. And a 5G phone would be able to fetch the data from this cloud storage. So as you can see, this becomes a very elaborate system, allowing you to find, as a manufacturer, the best answer to address the needs of your customer. So those things that are marked with this sign are will already be available for the first version of ETS6 coming to the market in autumn of this year.